In this ChatGPT tutorial for beginners, I'll show you how to use ChatGPT. You'll see what is ChatGPT and how to register for ChatGPT. I'll give you some ChatGPT examples and the basic beginner steps to use ChatGPT. Created by OpenAI, this model is free to use and you can use ChatGPT on iPhone, Android, or any computer. And if you don't know what ChatGPT is and you want to learn a little bit more about what it is, click the card above and I've got you covered. Okay, let's learn how to install and use ChatGPT. Okay, ChatGPT isn't something you actually need to install. You just need to access the web service from either a web browser or even your iPhone or Android device. But today we'll demonstrate using a web browser. The first thing you need to do is go to openai.com. OpenAI is the company that has produced ChatGPT. You can see at the top here, it's advertising this as its latest release. You can either click try at the top here or scroll down and come down to ChatGPT. Here's the info page telling you a little bit more about ChatGPT. You can scroll down and then again, click on try ChatGPT. Here it will ask you to either log in or sign up. Now, if you've already signed up, you just put in your login credentials. But today, as we're showing you how to register for ChatGPT, come over and click on sign up. Next thing you want to do is either put in an email address or sign in with a Google account or Microsoft account. But I'm going to create an account with an email address. Select I'm not a robot and then click continue. It will then ask you to put in a password. So I'll put in a password here. Make sure it's got at least 8 characters and then click continue. It will then send you a verification email to the email address you just registered with. So go ahead and open the Gmail. And here is the email that OpenAI have just sent me to verify my email address. So I'll go ahead and click that. Now it's asking for a little bit of information. So I'll put in my first and last name, click continue. And then I'll verify it with my phone number. And it will send a code to my mobile device, which I'll go ahead and put in. Great, that is now verified. And here we are at the ChatGPT interface. So a quick tour, every time you want to start a new chat, you can just go ahead and press new chat. You can flick to dark mode if you like. There's also a Discord here in case you want to get active with the community. There's also an updates and frequently asked question. So you can go through and learn a little bit more about the software model here. Okay, there's a little bit of a summary here. It's given some examples of what we might like to put in as a prompt. Tells you what some of the capabilities are of ChatGPT and then provides some limitations as to what you can expect out of it and what you cannot expect out of it. Now it says here that we don't get events after 2021. Now that is because ChatGPT uses its data set from time before 2021. So if you try asking it about current events, it won't know anything about it. Let's try clicking this one as a demonstration. So we type that in and press enter or the return button. And then at the top, you can see this is me at the top with my prompt, and then this is the ChatGPT. ChatGPT is thinking about it, and now here we go for some ideas. So this will take into account what 10-year-olds like and some ideas on what you can choose from, along with description as to what each type of idea entails. So I could ask it to either regenerate a response, in which case it would go ahead and create 5 new ideas. Or maybe I can get it to tell me more about idea 1. So it's given a little bit of a outline as to what the scavenger hunt is, but now here it's going to give you some specifics about how you can go away and prepare for this idea for a 10-year-old's birthday. So that's a really cool way. If you were to put those things into Google, it would probably take you a long time to scour the answers to find what you want. And after that, you'd have to go and Google again what the actual method is to go ahead and prepare that scavenger hunt. Let's go ahead and start a new chat. And now I'm going to say, tell me a joke. Not too bad. Tell me a joke about AI. What about if I ask it to regenerate a response? So rather than creating a new line, what it does when you click regenerate is it rephrases or regenerates what it had before. So if I were to ask it to rephrase that joke in first person, let's see if that works. Okay, so you can see how you can ask the AI, the ChatGPT, to do things based on what you want and ask it to modify its content based on tastes. Okay, let's start a new chat. Did you know there is another AI software that instantly generates original images from a short description that you prompt it with? This is an absolute game changer and means you can create any type of image you want and unleash your creativity. Click the link above to see a video about that software. Let's get it to write an adventure story in choose your own adventure style with three options based around the Game of Thrones, then prompt me to choose an option. Send that off. ChatGPT goes ahead and creates a story arc for me. And once it provides the options, I can choose an option. Let's go with this option. And now it generates the conclusion to that section of story. But now I want it to provide me with three options again. So I'll type this in and it will continue. I'll then go ahead and choose option three here. And then it comes and gives me another conclusion to another story. So that's a pretty cool way of creating a short story. Let's do another quick example of what you can ask ChatGPT to do. Write a short essay on why the sky is blue. ChatGPT thinks about it and then goes ahead and creates some content. You might even learn something as you read along with this. I could then go ahead and ask it to make longer or rephrase to add humor, but why would you want to do that in an essay? You could even say lengthen and rephrase from the point of view of Einstein. So that didn't really lengthen it, but it did add a little bit of a point of view from Einstein's theories of physics. Now that you know how to use ChatGPT, click here to learn more about what ChatGPT actually is and what you can do with it. People are already using it to even make money. So click that link now and I'll see you there.